This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about the law of cosines. So here's our first example. I've got a triangle, and I know the length of two of the sides. One side is 5 meters long, the other side is 9 meters long. And I know the size of the angle in between those two sides. We call this the included angle, and that's 63 degrees. I want to find the remaining side. We've got something called the law of cosines. The law of cosines says that if you know two sides of an angle, two sides of a triangle, and you know the included angle, the angle in between those two sides, you can find the remaining side. Okay, so the law of cosines is c squared equals a squared plus b squared minus 2 times a times b times the cosine of c. Now here's where the letters go. The angle we know is going to be angle c. The side opposite angle c will be side small c. The two remaining angles will be big A and big B. The side opposite angle A will be small a, and the side opposite angle B will be small b. Okay, so now that I've got these sides and angles labeled, I can fill in the numbers in this formula. So a is 5, I want 5 squared, and then I want b squared, b is 9, so that's 9 squared, minus 2 times a, which is 5, times b, which is 9, times the cosine of c, and the cosine of c is, or c, is 63 degrees. Okay, 5 squared is 25, and 9 squared is 81, and 2 times 5 is 10, 10 times 9 is 90. That's going to be negative 90 times the cosine of 63 degrees. Let's just add 25 and 81 before we go to the calculator. So 25 and 81 add up to 106 minus 90 times the cosine of 63 degrees. So this is what you would put into the calculator. I've already done that. And what I've got is that c squared equals approximately 65.14. Now that's c squared and we want c. So we'll take the square root. We're going to get c equals approximately 8.07. I'll round that up to 8.1. Okay, so now we know the length of the remaining side. That would be 8.1 meters. If we wanted to find the other two angles, we could use the law of sines, and we'd have enough information here to find those two angles. But I want to do another example with the law of cosines. So here's the second example. In this case, we've got a triangle, and we have all three sides. One side is 4 inches, one side is 5 inches, and one side is 7 inches. But let's say we want to find one of the angles. Let's say we want to find the angle at the top. So I'm going to call that angle C. That means the side opposite angle C we'll call small c. I'll label the other two angles A and B. The side opposite angle A will be small a, and the side opposite angle B will be small b. Now let's write that formula. That was c squared equals a squared plus b squared minus 2 times a times b times the cosine of c. And we'll fill in the numbers. So c is 7. I want 7 squared equals a squared. A is 6, is 4. So that's 4 squared plus b squared. B was 5. So that's 5 squared minus 2 times a, which is 4, times b, which is 5. Oops. 5 times the cosine of c. Well, 7 squared is 49, 4 squared is 16, 5 squared is 25. 2 times 4 is 8. 8 times 5 is 40, times the cosine of C. And let's subtract the 16 and the 25 from 49. When I take 49 and subtract 16, I get 33. And then when I take that 33 and subtract 25, I get 8. So I've got 8 equals negative 40 times the cosine of C. I'll divide both sides by negative 40, so I get negative 8 over 40 equals the cosine of C, and I can reduce negative 8 down to negative 1 over 5. So that's the cosine of C. I want to find C. If I know what the cosine of C equals, I can say that C equals the inverse cosine of that negative 1/5. So into the calculator, I would use the inverse cosine button and then take the inverse cosine of negative 1/5. I've done that already, and that equals approximately 101.5. Okay, so angle C is going to be approximately 101.5 degrees. Once again, if you wanted to find angles A and B, you could now use the law of sines and find those two remaining angles. Okay? So I hope that helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.